Hello class 5. Today I am going to start a new chapter from your syllabus, and this chapter is from geography. The name of this chapter is The Green Earth. Please take out your book and turn to page number 38. There you will get the chapter The Green Earth. So class 5, as you know that this chapter's name is Green Earth, so you can assume that this chapter mainly will have the trees and plants and everything. Okay, so India is a very rich country, and India is a very rich country because it is having lots of greenery. This green, that means this plant life and this trees, we are getting in two ways. Number one, that is natural way, and number two, that is cultivation. That means natural way means, that means we can say that forest. We are getting the forest trees, we are getting the forest plants, and that is all naturally. Nature is giving us this all these trees and plants, and we are getting these plants and trees naturally. So we can say that this is the natural process. And one is a cultivation. Through cultivation we get also plants and trees, like when we get the rice, when we are planting rice, when we are planting wheat, oil seeds and everything. So these are called that cultivation. With the help of the cultivation we get this thing. So in two ways we get the plant and trees. Number one, that is naturally, and number two, with cultivation. Now, as we know that trees are our friends, so what does a tree do? What is the function of the forest in our life? From the we get many things from the trees. The first thing, that is the oxygen, which with the help of this oxygen we are breathing. So it's very important. Another, that is food, furniture, we are getting the furniture also, that means we get medicines and everything. So many things are also there from the trees we are getting. So now in the page number 39 it is written, forest is our natural wealth. So why does a forest is called a natural wealth? There are some reasons. So we are going to discuss it. So students, you can see I have written some points on the board. So I told you that why this forest is called a natural wealth to us. Number one, it is, you can see that gives oxygen. So gives oxygen means, you know that plants take carbon dioxide and gives out the oxygen, give out the oxygen. And in this way, oxygen the thing that we need to breathe. So it is very important for us to take it. And therefore, forest help us to increase the oxygen level in the environment. Okay. So it, the first and foremost thing is that is the it is giving oxygen in the environment. Number two, the natural surroundings of the forest, homes to plants and creatures, means the natural surroundings of the forest are home to many plants and many creatures. Medicines, you can understand very well that it is forest, some kind of plants are having some medicinal values. So with the help of those plants we get the medicines. Last, that is grab the soil. What does it mean? In especially the hilly areas, when we see a trees are there, so trees can grab the soil with the help of those roots, with the help of the roots of this of the trees. Suppose when the rain falls, so what will happen? So the raindrops cannot take the soil easily from the ground. Okay, so when we can cut down a tree, so what will happen that time? There will be no root also. If there will be no root also, so what will happen, that easily that rain will take wash away the soil. So that is why we can say that grab the soil means here in hilly areas, forest help to protect the soil from being washed away by rain as the strong roots hold the soil together. Okay. Now we are going to, as we know that India is a vast country and India is a very, very vast country. So India, many parts of India is having different kinds of weather. Suppose like we are living in West Bengal and when we go to Rajasthan, we will see that the weather is totally different and the soil also. India is having the different kinds of soil. It's a very, very huge country, so different places have different kinds of soil. So according to the weather and soil, as we have different kinds of soils and different kinds of weather, so we have different kinds of trees also. Okay. Generally, we get two ways. We get the trees and everything, forest. So one is natural, another one is cultivated. Natural means we get naturally, when we get the natural when we get the trees and everything in natural way, that is sal, tea, grass, this all we get in natural process. But when we are when it is man-made, that means when we are cultivating the things, we get rice, wheat, jute, like that. Okay. Now here I also have written about food crop and cash crop. So what is that about the food crop and cash crop? Food crops are those that are used by the farmer and the extra is sold to other people. So that means rice, wheat, we are getting this, we are eating this. So after that, if it is extra, then the farmer is selling it. Okay. And cash crop is generally it's grown by the farmer to sell only, like oil seeds and jute and sugarcane and everything.